Hello, beloved. We are here again by the grace of God.
Adolfo, yes, thank you
for tuning into Radio Central
92.5.
This is Redemption Hour, where we bring hope for humanity.
Yeah, Redemption Hour. Yezi enyidar zeba zebra adesin na.
Let us pray.
Wama yen bompai. Dom erazi nyankopani mibri yedewasi. Yetun trum na yeshi wudzin konkru yin nyam wa yen ye abam bo mkwa idam hin ena apo mizin na mwadina idadin. Yes in shenka wudin.
Yes.
Na mehina kwen yesude. Yen te wasam. Na yen fansi sa yen abra bombo branchi wudzin konkru yin nyam. Jien tata ewo Jesus Christ nizin.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Beloved, we're looking at a topic that I've titled, someone I've titled, Fervent Prayer Works.
Nende nyubri, asampa yadibra wanye, asampa nitsidi de, mpaya ba, nani ye naman, oye juma.
Fervent prayer yields results. James chapter 5 verse 16.
James,
it talks about fervent prayer.
Okasafa,
now listen.
Say,
we should confess our faults to one another. Pray for one another. And he says the effective fervent prayer of a righteous person has great power. So fervent prayer by the righteous has great power. When we talk about the righteous, people think we are talking about perfect humanity. Scripture has declared that there's none perfect. None of us can claim our own perfect righteousness. But God's grace comes to us because he sent his only begotten son to die in our stead. And he shed his blood to cover our sins so that as many as believe in him, he will make them children of God. Scripture says he was perfect, sinless.
Now choice am kade. Oh Jesus, ono afuzibian yu mfumbian yun.
And so he became the lamb that was slain for humanity.
And see obeye gwamba wasn't quick me zema
understand. It is this man, Jesus, that makes us, imputes his righteousness unto us.
Na dem berma Jesus e ona nanangasa odenete ni nyataren odeshian.
So when we say the fervent prayer of a righteous person has great effect, we are talking about the prayer of someone who has dedicated himself to Christ.
And it say kade obi a oye tin ni nim pai bonu a oye tin nim itun woman ye piache de. Ibia Jesus nansezi nubweje au huo nuhu na ordina ye nezen dami nyimpan na mpaibwan na ye itum mpaibwan.
Sometimes we go into desperate situations.
Otofe bia na ya ke jina pempendi bia inyankese ye jihenwa anji.
And you don't feel like praying.
Ibona inyati nke biarade ebobo mpai.
And you think that there's somebody else who should come and do the prayer for you.
And so I am a wagner door today, it be full of bobon pay more.
Because you don't have confidence in yourself.
Since I ain't a worry, you're a shimbier in you.
But the confidence I'm talking about is not about your ability to do things through prayer.
Nah, the monkasa from here, one kasa, one who can't, it's a bobo and pay.
we've been discussing about King Jehoshaphat.
And I yet in Komobi Efa or King Jehoshaphat but the Kenaba
tried to live right and please God.
Ah, Obanum wasn't there. Obat's not in him, not was he rising.
Having walked in the steps of his father, King Asa.
Ah, Oye Neja, Asa, Onantu Neja Nasa, Nanamorim.
Jehoshaphat made a terrible mistake when he went down to King Ahab.
And so Jehoshaphat, Oyam Fum Kasim Ra, Oden Ho Kabata, Oyin Aha.
Even though Ahab was also from God's people.
Na.
Yes, he was from Israel. And he, Jehoshaphat, is the king of Judah. But Israel did not have respect. I mean, the king of Israel did not have respect for God. Beloved, you have people like that who call themselves Christians, call themselves going to church, but they don't really respect God. Because of how they behave and what they believe, what they do in communities. Beloved, listen. God knows those who are his. So Jehoshaphat went to this place. We learned it last week, or we talked about it last week. And so when he did that, the Bible says he made a room for demons, forces of darkness to come into his life. Now, for somebody whom God has given the freedom from war, suddenly the enemies began to attack.
And
so when the prophet came to tell him that, yes, because of what you have done, you will be at
war.
But when God says he is against you, there's nothing you can do.
You
can't change it by yourself. All you need to do is surrender more to God. There are many people who have backslided, who have done things, and they sense within them the judgment of God. And yet, they are not willing to come back. They remain so stubborn.
And so now, so then, now why?
But Jehoshaphat didn't do that.
Now Jehoshaphat is the one yet them.
He went to God in prayer.
Or son, let you pray. What do I want?
He fasted.
Or chill, come.
Asked his people to fast.
Now, or son, no money, you other one chill.
He learned something about his prayer.
Now, me pede, yes, you be one of
my bones. A fervent prayer.
Or bom paya, nanu yazan.
So we're going to take 2 Chronicles chapter 25 to 12. And let's listen to how he prayed. We want people to understand that it is not, praying to God is not the purview of some special people.
You
may not feel confident, but I'm saying that God sees you and God wants you to come to him just as you are. Despite the backslidden state of Jehoshaphat.
Jehoshaphat, Sriwa, another patra, as he asa, or she in Nina, as a twin channel.
2 Chronicles 25 to 12. Let's do that today.
Woman, Yanje,
Jehoshaphat stood before the community of Judah and Jerusalem in front of the courtyard of the temple of the Lord.
Now, Jehoshaphat, Ojina, Judah, Manning, now, Hunenim, Ewo, Jerusalem, Asodan, Wo Irazenim.
And he prayed.
No, Bompai.
Oh Lord, the God of our ancestors. You alone are the God who is in heaven. You are ruler of all the kingdoms of the earth. People ridicule Christians, and because we also are not confident in the God we serve, they think that there is no God. Jehoshaphat said, "You are powerful and mighty."
Jehoshaphat, damna nempai bonu mwake. Osi owe razi iye tumfu ene ye huozini.
And no one can stand against you.
No biara nywa obotum waku etiam.
And then he reminded God.
And okay, razi.
Did you not drive out those who lived in this land when your people Israel are right here?
And
did you not give this land forever to the descendants of your friend Abraham? The descendants of Abraham.
Abraham asimbebi.
Your people settled here and built temple to honor your name.
Now, one crawfu. What sinaha and what see a sodan that was the best show.
And he said, whenever we are faced with calamities such as war,
Nada, what can you say? Say, was ya a coon, another, or tabby behind the day, or Sada Wokwa,
or famine,
another, comet zinzana.
We can come and stand in your presence before this temple where your name is honored.
Ye botum ya ba dam a serve fi nenim.
Oh beloved.
Ya wangasa wen yim yam ashe.
When people refuse to realize that the house of God is special.
Nase mkrofu wopu. Na wobu wen yo gududa nyankupwani fie o yasun kwa.
The house of God must be honored.
God is honored.
When you identify a place as God's, a place where you worship God, God is honored. And so when he said this, he said, the people said, we can cry out to you to save us. And you will hear and rescue us. It was an assurance that the people had with God. Then he brought the plea. Now see what the armies of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir are doing. You would not let your ancestors invade those nations when Israel left Egypt.
Na emahukwan madam Ammon fui won tunsa wankasa umba hondu wombra
it's the other way around. You not let your ancestors invade these nations when they came to this place.
Na ama wankasa wasimba wanse dam asasidu.
So they went around them and did not destroy them. So they left them as they are. Now see how they reward us. You didn't let our people destroy them. Now they have come to throw us out of the land you gave us.
They
have come to take our property. Oh God.
Oh, Erase.
Won't you stop them?
Ana insu hankwan.
We are powerless against this mighty army.
Eya the tumbia ni hemu dam and sudafu akasa akasa otide ni.
We do not know what to do.
Yenhuza yenye.
But we are looking to you for help.
Nemom yeshawe Erase womwa.
This is a desperate prayer.
When you
look at this prayer,
he
was not a regular person who prays every day like a champion deliverer or somebody. But when the period of desperation came, look at the content of his prayer.
He expressed
confidence in the Lord.
Confidence
in the works of the Lord. Hebrews 11:6 says, if you come, you who comes to God must believe that he is, and he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
No, Hebrews, it's in the order in the perfect and one hour be razin or said that what you tune there on a razin waho. Na, and one hour, what the akuma shishanon.
So when you are desperate,
and she said, it caught them, Sibunuma,
come confidently before the Lord.
Faku could you brave razin
and express confidence?
Na, da,
because if you come before you need to believe him. Don't doubt him.
And
secondly, know your identity.
Now, one can say,
Jehoshaphat knew his identity.
Jehoshaphat is in on him.
Look, God, we belong to you. We are your servants. We are descendants of your friend Abraham.
Abraham.
So, beloved, if you have faith in Jesus.
And see, Adolfo said, well, Jesus, ever Jesus, man.
Know your identity.
Yeah,
it's true that Jehoshaphat fell. He sinned against God.
Jehoshaphat, but
he remembered who he was.
Nenso, okay, yeah, oh, yeah.
You might have fallen.
Ebiana,
you might have gone astray.
Ebiana,
but remember who you are. Know your identity.
Okay, yeah,
yeah. And then come to God confidently. Again, he remembered his God's promises.
Now,
so when we come to prayer,
when
we are praying fervently, let's express confidence in the Lord. Let's know our identity. Let's remember God's promises. Psalm 50:15. Call on me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me.
It's
a promise of the Lord. It says, in the day of trouble, when you are in distress, when you are desperate, yes, you've sinned and it looks like all hell broke loose.
And so all your them nyamimpo onyu ho.
But God says,
nyamisi,
if you're in trouble,
se wo homa,
my child,
maba,
call upon me.
I will suffer.
Call me.
Suffer.
I will deliver you.
Nami na majo.
And you will honor me.
Na izenyim nyam
amo. God is faithful. He keeps to his word.
Nyami anukofu na nasam de umbundi aduda.
Despite these great things,
Jehoshaphat
realized.
Jehoshaphat is
he acknowledged his limitation with humility.
He
can't do without you. Sometimes we come to God with such arrogance because we think that we are becoming and we think we can command God to do everything. No. We hold God to his promises, but we can't command him to do our bidding.
Na aya na yedi amadubi na yedi beradin anim da meba kabia ya shende osede oye nanso ye ntum yan yan dam wo ekwana ihankasa ya hwedo.
Joseph expressed confidence in the Lord.
Joseph at the oda areshem we radin
knew his identity.
Na ankasa hunu hoti
da remembered God's promises.
Okay, radin ansa no boshe.
And then acknowledge his limitations with humility.
Na ankasa hun na ankasa nembro ya.
Finally, he took God at his word.
Let's
learn to take God at his word. Beloved, I love this passage in Isaiah chapter 60, verse
22.
Isaiah 22. Listen, in the New Living Translation, it says, the smallest family will become 1,000 people.
Amen. I see. Nebusia kuma bi obeye busia oya mpimpim.
And the tiniest group will become a mighty nation.
Ena iku kakrebe bisu obeye oye omana kasi ankasa.
At the right time.
Nimbipim.
I, the Lord, will make it happen.
Mammy Erazi Mama Wabum.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take God at His word. God saves not by the multitude. He saves but because of His great power.
No Oji. Since I then tuna or son Oji.
He receives us because He is agape.
Oji Henitum or send or honingi.
Come, let us reason together.
Also,
Jehoshaphat heard, he sinned against God. He went down into sin.
Jehoshaphat of Fumezi or Patrizi Nansu or Keshabonumizi and so.
So yet when he came to his senses,
Embranangasa Obanohodunu
prayed a desperate prayer.
And
the title says, fervent prayer yields results.
Now, yes, I'm putting it in there.
Beloved, rather than depending on the prayers of others, and always running to people to pray for you,
my job is to
teach people and give them the confidence that you can go to God in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Nami zi meni gen de metreo mehu eze akukudu a akwe razine nyim wampai bo.
And you can confidently develop your own prayer for deliverance at any time.
Na wanga se botu mizi akukudu du na eze mpai bo a oyo ajim mpai bo ne eza yejuma abribia.
And when you follow some of these points that even Jehoshaphat made.
Na se izi. Expressing
confidence in the Lord. When you come to God, don't feel useless. Don't think that it's all over and that nothing's gonna express confidence in the Lord.
Know
your identity. Look, the prodigal son went so wayward.
Nah, oba the self onzi or patri kra.
But he knew his identity.
Nancy no nyimbo.
I have a father.
Awesome wager.
Ah, even slaves are eating, and I'm eating from this place.
Nah, mkwampo wazi wazi zibampa
shatter. So know your identity.
Look,
when you fall into sin, it doesn't mean that Jesus Christ has departed from your life.
Nah, say, patsu tobonuma, ono nchede, Jesus, if you are brabo mkwa kwa.
You can come and be renewed.
Remember
the promises of God. Remember the promises. Call upon me in the day of trouble. All this in humility.
And
when you take God at His word,
He says,
I, the Lord, will make it happen. So you also can receive deliverance. Look, you see, we've made deliverance like some miracle that only some people can do. You as an individual, in your room, in your prayer time, when you join others to pray, if you follow the Lord's word, these principles confidently, God will show His might on your side.
Amen.
This is what we call proper worship. Listen, honest, selfless worship. Honest, selfless worship is important for people to receive immediate attention from the Lord. Especially during times of distress and crisis.
And
when you don't expect,
Na se wenyin da.
The Lord comes through.
Na nyame epuem.
In the time of Jehoshaphat, as he was praying.
Before the people,
he hadn't been promised that God is going to speak or anything. He just prayed faithfully.
By faith.
And then suddenly God chose somebody to prophesy to Jehoshaphat and all Israel.
Judah, man,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Look, if members of churches and religious groups are being honest in our time with the Lord,
and
we make ourselves available to the Lord, the Lord can use you at a time when you never expect. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you are available to the Lord,
you
will lack nothing in your warfare against the devil.
I
want to encourage us, beloved. Focus on desiring God constantly.
Dream
about it. Dream about it. Talk about it. And work at it conscientiously. Fervently. And scripture says there will be great results. Let me remind us that James 4:8 says, when you draw near to God, He will draw near to you.
And see, James, it's an ninchichema or chenicade. Se echiben eraza. Erazaso ochibianu.
God only draws near to us when we take the initiative to draw near to Him.
Na nyami ochiben hin. Se yankase yet dinkan to anamande yer chabiana on erazichiben.
Draw near to Him and He will draw near to you.
Se Ichibena, onusu bwacha.
You cannot remain in your stagnant place and in a sin and expect God to be coming to you. God knows, He knows you. If you're a child of God, you are backslided like Jehoshaphat. Draw near to God and God will draw near to you.
Na men jina u jina biyum. De en kwa chungu aba. Ebya etibwene mwete. Enso, setan omwa ne chibene raza. Raza bwacha na abyanu.
If you hear His voice, Jehoshaphat, do not harden your hearts. God delights not in formulas.
A
genuine prayer from the heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'd like to read finally before I open the phone lines, Jeremiah chapter 29, 12 to 14.
Na mi pere yekan Jeremiah iti idunu akun.
And so, listen carefully.
Into woman, into
Jeremiah chapter 29:12-14.
Jeremiah, it's a donor crown, ninchem debian.
Fervent prayer.
What's in Paiwa?
Based on the word of God.
Ah, Ojina Erasina.
Then you will call me, you call on me, and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and you will find me when you seek me with all your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord, and will bring you back from captivity. I will gather you from all the nations and places where I have banished you.
Na maka wana buwanu biyo biya manga samo bo wana pitin masana kan wana buwanu
and I'll bring you back
na mazu wana ba manga samin
chen this is God of love
iye nyamia odasha numa
who opened the open lines for somebody who wants to share testimony or you want to confirm this word or you want to ask a question but the promise is God listens prayer
amen inti yebwe ahumatrufu natum me ewasembi bisa Asam to bibika and answer the yakin, you best do tell you the other in your oil and a cora. Nyami, Wamon who can in the new breed, in the fray, Albany CCR.
The phone numbers are 03321. I'll ask the producer to give us the numbers. So when you call, just ask any question or contribution. We are talking about fervent prayer yields great results.
In say fry, but maybe sa same ya and other some to do be a can.
And we are
may I can you there? In Paiwa, or ye in Yibirim Paibono.
And we have seen how Jehoshaphat.
Yehu, a corner Jehoshaphat, or
and got great results.
Na nempai bono so odi ya na nimu ye dri de bay
03321. I'll get that for you very soon. But if personally you want to continue this discussion with me,
na se si da nkranko e pede enyimi di da masem ni ho nkomo a,
you can call me on 0246894250.
See, I don't know about our dinner, genius of the Yinan Casana
0331 94880.
And see, I've been now adding it in. But
my phrase is hello,
yes, hello.
Oh, could you please see the
colonel? Thank you, could you?
And you said, you're young, but you see. No, my dear. The company, the company is a man, may I can be ever seen my year. May I catch him back? That's all about Wastel, Anna.
Yes. Nine, I am Bible. God bless you. That's exactly what I was saying. A bit Cain, na in your show, no more. Na a Cain, no bush or damo. Okay. Na a bronze. When you humble yourself, take God at His word. That is prayer. Yes, hello. 03321 94880. Somebody is also on the personal line, but I'll take it for this time. Yes, hello, Mr. Eni. Hello. Yes. Good evening. Yamna Dumara. Yes. Yes. So what you're saying is that you don't have to put your trust in men. Even if you go to a man of God, a woman of God, remember, trust in the Lord and do not put your trust in man. That's why I cited Jehoshaphat, who had fallen, who had gone into sin.
And
when he prayed fervently, acknowledging those things, God spoke, God gave a direction, and victory came. So deliverance will come when we are faithful. When we pray, our heart out. You don't have to depend on people telling you. You don't always have to buy oil, buy soap, buy Florida water, buy things before God can hear your prayer. Let me tell you, we only ask in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Inti onyede eboto oye angobi anai kutubi anabibi osede ebompai ewo Jesus nizim na yetin ye residi shone numu.
The word of God.
Nyami nasan.
That we read.
Ah, ye kanen.
Never ask us to put our trust.
Ono on shen yende yem fen yem re yin shen yin pe bim.
In elements or human beings. Anade
ndama ndama bim.
03320-94880. 03320-94880. 03320-91870. 03320-91870. You can call and share your testimony, ask a question, or whatever it is. Just want to ask that by the grace of God, we have we've been granted an extra 15 minutes. That's why we have more time to make to receive calls. So call right now, and we are waiting for you. We have a few minutes left. 03320-91870 or 94880. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Good evening.
Good evening. Pachoka, sir. Pachoka, sir.
Honey, there. If there are all the new na good law on pay. Na all the new na or cadet. The make a one can imagine. Or get a bacassa or a kid nature, or yeah, also a monte. Now, I'm interested in the monte now, doing him or Bono, but you are monte about the same age, as I send you now, other worker. But Sunday, where's the kind one work has that the lady, but you work again? I mean, is it biblical? One kind of means that you have no monte, there's a 5 minutes of work, come on, okay, now, is it biblical?
Thank you very much. So his question is, sometimes some leaders lead the congregation to repeat after them and they say a couple of things and then later tell them to pray. So what is the need? What I'm saying is this, God even doesn't want unnecessary repetition. Sometimes we just repeat things and we make things and we extend it so that we have prayed for 10 hours or 12 hours when in actual fact it's just been repetition. But the important thing we teach people is that your faith, confidence in the Lord, focus prayer, ask and you shall receive.
Now, the year change there, one kasa, one pibo, is when you see a razi, nedun, na is all rash, numun, oh no, an osibisa, na one sabbat.
So, beloved, I just want to say that we can't judge people, but we have good money and we have counterfeits.
Na yen tum buanko for atan. Now, of course, I mean, there, Sika, you were Sika Papa, now you were there, where you are from.
Let's seek, you and I, and all those who are hearing us, let's seek to be genuine children of God.
And not
depending upon people. Trying to do gymnastics with the word of God. No. No, faith. Few more minutes,
03320-94880.
So King Jehoshaphat gives us a clear example. Hello, somebody on the line.
Hello.
Yes.
Good evening, Reverend.
Please tune down your radio a little bit.
Okay. Good evening, Reverend.
Yes. Good evening.
Good evening, Michelle. I'm Dominic. But then move on there. The Lord's Prayer.
Yes.
Talking using that to the magic formula, whatever you want to say.
Yes, thank you very much. So you want to know how people use the Lord's Prayer as if it's a magic form of prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. So we always do that. Now, let me make it clearly. if you look at the Lord's Prayer, there's a format.
Okay, if ye Jesus in Bible or chair is here for now,
you're teaching us
in Shishabia or Father the Chair.
Pray like this.
It's yam bon pay or damu
kwan. It's not pray these words.
Oh, one kade dam in some pay na wakanan or say bon pay.
So there are points, there are things that we need to know. Honoring God, humbling ourselves, accepting our limitations, etc., and taking God at His word. So people can just recite the word of, the Lord's Prayer by rote, and that doesn't mean anything. God gives us the opportunity to ask for specific things in our lives. And that's what you teach. 0332094880. We are almost there. Just about 3 minutes. 0332091870. We'll be glad if you can call and ask a question or share your testimony. But I pray that tonight's teaching tool will put people in greater confidence in coming before the Lord.
Amen. Me jizi yede ende nyubri adisye Obama himu duduwa yinyadam akukudrin daba eradine nyim ewan paibon.
So if you want to take Jehoshaphat's form of prayer, what he did was this. Express confidence in the Lord. Knew his identity. Remembers the promise of God. And then acknowledge his limitations.
Humbly.
To God at his word.
Hebrew
says, without faith, it is impossible to please God.
In your Hebrew form,
will there be a last caller? Will you be the last caller for tonight? 0332094880 0332091870, whichever. Anybody can call. We're so glad to be with you tonight. I want to thank you. We're going to close the line now. And want to say, seek the Lord. In times of these, we need the deliverance of the Lord.
The
deliverance has to be real and practical. Our focus tonight is fervent prayer yields results. Thank you very much. God richly bless you. Hopefully next week we'll meet again.
Now, all your rising prayer, the Sunday, your best in Asia, you.
So my personal line is 0246894250, 0246894250. If you call, you're calling to Redemption Hour program or the pastor in charge, and we always bring it to you on Monday evenings, 7:15.
And see, so Penny number and all that too. Igwan, oh yeah, Redemption, I'm sorry, yes, of Penny, and Redemption Hour. So far, Odi and Kanyin, Inti, I bring the about my friend, no new being.
God bless you, God bless Radio Central.
Nyami Isha, Radio Central, and then Mujumazifunya, Razima, Ujuman, Untum Punche, Razin,
thank you for listening to us.
Yet the one I see there, Umti.
Amen.
Amen.